Okay, so today we are trying to explain about the development of funnel by Santosh S. G. and my Ravi Kumar T. Vinay Kumar, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Sai Vidyesh of Technology, Bangalore. See, this is the given figure. We need to, by using this given figure, we need to draw the developmental of funnel. Okay, we'll be having two parts. One is frustum of cone, another one is a cylinder. Okay, so this frustum of cone you can construct in a different way, but here we are trying to explain it in the both the cases. So easiest we will explain the very easiest method. Okay, so this is the frustum of cone. See, if you cut it in a horizontal, you know, horizontal direction, you will get the frustum of cone. Okay, so we'll try to construct the first front and top view of this frustum of cone. Okay, and then cylinder. See, this is a total development of funnel. Okay, so here base circle will be 80 mm. And so in the cylinder circle will be 20 mm diameter, and then cylinder height will be 30 mm, and then frustum height will be 60 mm. Okay, so by using this we need to draw front and top view. See here, see, first take 40 mm radius. So take 40 mm radius. Okay, so then from the same, so this is the base circle radius is completed. Next, we need, if you're looking from top of an object, so base circle is 80 mm, and then so by center one is a 20 mm. So we need to construct that. So with the same center, it's just like a concentric circle. So with the same center, you just use 10 mm radius, and you will get the circle. Okay, so this is 20 mm circle, and outside will be 80 mm circle. So project the line upward. Project the line upward. So up to XY line. Similarly from this side. Okay, again from this side. From this side. Project the line upward. Okay, then after that you need to know the this length of the cylinder. So this length of the cylinder will be 30 mm. Okay, so from this point you take height is 30. Take height is 30. Okay, then after that, see, you need to construct, you need to take the length of frustum of cone. So frustum of cone length will be 60 mm from the from the base of the cylinder to the top of the cylinder. Okay, frustum of cone. So this height will be 60 mm. So from this point you take 60. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, see, 60, you just draw one straight line. Then join this corner to this corner. Okay, join this, and then similar way in this side over. So then project, you need to project the line up to the top surface of the frustum of cone. So if you project it, so then you will came to know, so it is connected. Okay, then draw axis line. Without the axis line you can't able to identify whether it is a funnel or rectangle or triangle, so don't forget to mention axis line. Okay, so actually this is the given figure, so you need to mention the dimensions. So diameter is 80. Next, so this diameter is 20. Okay, and then height of the cylinder you need to make sure. So this height of the cylinder will be 30. Okay, then height of the frustum is 60. Okay, so this is actually given figure. So by using this given figure, so we need to do the development of funnel. frustum of cone, next is cylinder. Okay, see, we can do it very easily with a one single diagram. See, you extend this slant edge up to the axis line. Okay, and similarly do this side. See, if you join, okay, so you will get the axis point. So from this axis point, so you find out the slant edge length. Okay, so don't take vertical height length, you need to find out the slant edge length. So if you find out the slant edge, it will be around the 95 we got. So we got, this is around 95 mm, so this is a slant edge length. Okay, this is 95 mm. Okay, so next, by using this, we need to find out the angle. So angle, how to find out angle? See, we'll be having theta is a, you know, formula for this to find out the angle is base radius of cone. So it's a capital R. So to avoid confusion, please write here capital R and small r. Okay, this is a base radius of cone and slant edge length. So it is a capital L. Okay, you can take capital L clear into 360 degree. Okay, so we have base circle radius is 80 mm diameter and radius will be 40 mm, and then slant edge length will be 95. So 95 into 360 degree. So if you do that, you'll get theta. Okay, so see here, 40 divided by 95 into 360 degree. Okay, so you'll get around 151.57 degree. Okay, so this is the frustum of cone angle. We need, you know, next we'll develop, we'll do the development in the next another sheet. See, if you expand, this is a frustum of cone. If you expand it, you'll get like this. Okay, so we need to construct like this in the sheet. Okay, so take, see, this will be a slant edge will be 95 mm. See, take 95 mm, one straight line here, horizontal line. Take 95 mm horizontal line. See, after that, take angle. It will be 151, so I'll take 152 degree. 151.57 is there, so I'll take 152. See, from the center point, you take angle. See, up to here 90, so 150, then 152. Okay, 150 and 152. Okay, now, so next, similar way, you draw on line. Okay, draw one line. Next, use compass with the same 95 mm slant edge length. Draw an arc. Okay, draw an arc. See, next is, this will be 95 mm arc, and show this angle. So this angle will be theta is equal to 152 degree. Okay, see, after that, you need to cut this portion, right? So how to cut this portion? See, we have done here. See, from the up, from this point to this point, it's a frustum of cone, and if you extended this, it will be a cone. Okay, so we need to remove from this point portion. So how to remove it? You just use compass. Okay, from the apex up to the 30 mm height of the cylinder, you select the, you know, select the dimension from the your compass. Okay, next, from the same apex, you know, from the same midpoint, center point, you just draw an arc. Okay, just draw an arc. So this portion will be, this portion will be cutted, hatchet portion will be cutted, and then leave 5 mm in both the side for seaming operation. So leave 5 mm.
So leave 5 mm for in both the sides for seaming. See, I'm doing a hatch for that. So it's not a removed, it's used for only seaming operation. So please mention in both the side 5 mm for seaming. Okay, so this is actually frustum of cone. Okay, so next we need to construct another cylinder. Okay, to construct the funnel. Okay, we required another second part. So this will be a first part, and second part is cylinder. So to find, you need to find out the length of the cylinder. So how to find out length of the cylinder? See, length of the cylinder will be having formula is equal to 2 pi r. So this r will be a radius of the cylinder. Okay, so 2 into pi into radius of the cylinder is how much? So it is a diameter is 20 and radius will be 10. So you will get length of the cylinder will be 2 into pi into 10. So you will get 62.83 mm. So I will take 63 mm. So to round off I will take 63 mm. So here take 63 1 2 3 4 5 6, then 6.1 6.2 6.3. okay, so then take height of the cylinder will be 30 mm. You take 30 mm. Okay, and then leave 5 mm in both the side for seaming. Please mention 5 mm. Next, just mention the length. So this will be, I'll take 63 mm. Okay, then 5 mm. So this will be for seaming operation. Okay, so this is the second part and this is first part. So okay, so this one will be a frustum of cone and this one is cylinder. See, if in the lab if they given to construct only frustum of cone, so you need to do up to here. Okay, only this part. So if you mention to do funnel, you need to do both. Okay, so we'll join. For joining, frustum of cone and funnel, we'll use soldering operation. But for joining the funnel, frustum of cone, we'll use only seaming, and similarly for cylinder, only seaming. But for joining cylinder and frustum of cone, we'll use soldering operation. Okay. So here all dimensions are in mm. Okay. So next part we'll be do it in the sheet metal. Okay, will be explained by Vinay Kumar. Okay, see, whatever we did in the manual, same thing will be carried on the sheet metal sheet. Okay, so that is done by Vinay Kumar. So first take reference line. Okay, and find out the midpoint. So select one midpoint there. Select one midpoint and draw an arc. Draw an arc. Then use protractor to take angle. So angle will be 151.57, so we'll take 152, 130, 140, 150, 152. So we'll take straight line, which
touches the arc. So next is, we need to draw one cutted portion arc. See, from up to the etching point. Reference to up to etching point. Okay. Then leave 5 mm in both the sides for seaming. Okay, so next, better use a marker where it will be visible, so while cutting it will not go wrong. Okay, so this 5 mm for seaming, and similarly here 5 mm for seaming. Okay. So next, we need to in the same sheet we need to take this length of the cylinder, okay, because in the same shape we need to construct cylinder also. So cylinder length will be 63, so sir is taking 63 now, so length is 30, 63 plus 5, okay, 63 plus 5 is around 68, because 5 mm for that side the seaming. So, and even we need to take this side also 5 mm for seaming. Seaming, okay. So this is second part and this one is first part. This is the first arm of cone and this one is a cylinder. Okay, sheet metal tools are required to do this, you know, funnel operation. So this is a nose player, okay, and this one is side snip and wooden mallet and round stake, okay, and this one is funnel stake. Okay, so this one is a funnel stake. So next we'll do the cutting operation by using side snip. Okay, so first be careful to cut, okay. So inside you need to remove the material. So this is frustum of cone, okay. So next we'll go for bending. So one is opposite and another one is in opposite direction. This should be in opposite direction. Okay. So see, one is one direction, another one is opposite direction. So with the help of, you know, a round stick, so we need to bend. So this is seaming. This is funnel stick, so use funnel stick. Okay, so this is first term of cone, so first part. So next we need to go for second part, so cylinder. So we need to bind. Here also same, one is one same direction, another one is opposite direction, another one in different direction or opposite direction. So we join these two. So this is first term of cone and this is a cylinder, and if you attach these two you'll get funnel. Okay, next we'll go for soldering operation. We need to apply the flux. Okay, so next is solder. So just we'll do soldering now. Okay, only where the two gaps are there, you just apply the solder and complete the soldering operation. So this is soldering operation. Okay. So this is the funnel. Okay. Thank you.